Let's take a moment and talk about converting units. This is something we do very often in chemistry or any physical science, and it's really just a way of processing information. I love to say it, if you watch enough of these videos or you're in my class, you'll hear it, units, units, units. I love to say it because it emphasizes just how important the units are. Remember, for us, numbers are just a tool. It's really information that we care about, and a number with a unit represents information. The unit provides the context for the number. Now, you could ask yourself, you know, what the appropriate unit is in any particular problem. And in fact, that's not necessarily that simple a question, because the unit I want depends on what I'm doing. And there's really sort of two groups of units. And we're going to want to learn to interconvert between both of them, right? There's different units that represent the same physical property, and we'll talk in a minute about length. There are different units that all are measurements of length, and that's what I mean by different units for the same physical property. There's also, of course, different units which represent different physical properties. So if you consider, for example, length and time, these represent two different physical properties, and so there are different units that apply to each one of them. And ultimately, we want to learn to convert between both units that measure the same physical property and units that measure different physical properties. For the purposes of this discussion, we're going to focus only on the first case, different units for the same physical property. So let's consider length for a minute. Length is one of four principal measurements that can be undertaken. We talked about this earlier, and it represents one of four pure units. Now, length can be measured in really an infinite number of things. The common ones in the U.S. would be inches or feet or yards or miles, the so-called English units of measure. For most of the rest of the world, the metric system applies, and so there's meters or kilometers or micrometers or millimeters or centimeters or any other metric unit of length. And of course, there's other sort of specialized units like light years. But in fact, you could define your own unit of length. All you need is a stick that has a defined length, and that becomes your standard. So there's really an infinite number of units I could use to measure length. Now, if I want to convert between different systems or different units, I need to find the relationship between those different units. And in the case of length, it's really just a question of lining them up side by side. Now, suppose I, being a little obsessed with myself, decide to define my own unit of length, call it a joe. All I need is a stick labeled Joe, and I can lay that end to end with any other object I want to measure. Now, Sandy, being a good American girl, prefers to use the more standard feet as a measurement, and Johnny, being a good old Irish boy, wants to use the more common metric unit of meters. But we can all measure the same object using our respective sticks just by laying them side by side. So let's say for a moment that I have a stick and I measure it using my Joe stick and I find it to be 3.6 Joes long. Sandy takes her standard ruler, she lays it side by side with the stick, and she finds the stick is 1 foot long. And then Johnny takes his European measuring stick and finds that that stick is 0.3048 meters long. Now, if I look at just the numbers, it seems like I have three different measurements of the same stick. But of course, there's only one stick. So those three different measurements all have to be equivalent. They're all equal to one stick. So in fact, I could define what's essentially conversion factors between the different systems of measurement. That 1 foot stick that Sandy measured was 3.6 Joes. Since it's the same stick, those two measurements have to be equal. The numbers aren't equal, but the number coupled with the unit has to be equal. Similarly, the 1 foot that Sandy measured has to be the same as the 0.3048 meters that Johnny measured, because they were measuring the same object, and so this also creates an equality. These equalities are what I mean by conversion factors, relationship between different units of measure, and I can actually use them to solve problems. This method is called either dimensional analysis in some texts or factor label method, but it relies on the existence of these conversion factors, these relationships between different units of measure. And really, all I need to do is carefully keep track of the units and find the appropriate conversion factors to solve many very simple problems, and some even fairly complex problems, because again, ultimately, all we're doing is processing information, and units represent information. And so for us, it's always about the units. It may not be the only thing you need to consider in a problem, but it always needs to be considered. Conversion factors really are all about the power of one, the number one, because one, as you might recall, is the multiplicative identity, as it's called. If you multiply any number by one, it doesn't change its value. My weight times one is still my weight. I don't get heavier or lighter. $10 is still $10. If I multiply it by one, I don't get more or less money. Now, this might seem like a rather trivial math problem, but if I'm clever about the form of my one, it actually becomes a very powerful way to solve problems. So let's consider this equality. 1 foot equals 12 inches. Now, as a conversion factor, what I want to do is turn this equality into a one. And so there's two ways I could do this. Either I divide both sides by 12 inches, they cancel and give me a 1, right? That creates the relationship that 1 foot divided by 12 inches is a 1. Or I could have done the reverse, which is divide both sides by 1 foot. In both cases, what I end up with is a ratio of two different units that equals 1. And so I should be able to multiply anything I want by that ratio without changing its value. Now, in principle, I could take $10 out of my pocket and multiply it by that ratio, and it's still the same amount of money, but the units here become a little more complicated and, in fact, somewhat meaningless. So I can multiply anything I want by that ratio without actually changing its value, but I want to keep track of the units and end up with the unit that gives me the piece of information I want. So let's take a simple example, my height. I'm 73 inches tall, and I'd like to convert that to feet. Now, I know you can probably do this in 10 seconds almost without thinking, but how do you actually do it? And the answer really is dimensional analysis. Any problem, like any journey, is really a path between two points. And so when I start any problem, I always ask myself two questions. The first thing, what do I know? And again, since I'm obsessed with units, 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 I'm really phrasing this question in respect to units. What units do I start with? And of course, journeys have a beginning and an end, so the second thing I always ask myself is, what do I want to know? Or again, since I'm obsessed with units, what units do I want to end up with? So, in terms of units, this gives me a starting point and an ending point for solving my problem. And there's many, many problems where this is all I need to do to solve them. The solution to any problem is just a question of finding the right conversion factors to create a path from where I'm starting unit-wise to where I want to end. So in this particular case, the thing I know at the very beginning is that I'm 73 inches tall. So the unit I'm starting with is inches. And I also know that I want to end with feet, because of course the question asks me how many feet is that. So the unit I want to end up with is feet. And the game here is simply to multiply by one, or a whole series of ones, such that I'm not changing the value, I don't want to get taller or shorter, but I'm changing the units. And so I need to find conversion factors that will convert my units that I'm starting with, in this case inches, to the units I want to end up with, feet. And of course we've already seen a relationship between inches and feet, and we're going to essentially use that. Now in general, if I didn't automatically know the conversion, I at least half know what I'm looking for. Because here's the thing, I'm starting with inches. Since that's not what I want to end up with, I want to get rid of inches. So whatever I'm going to do next, and really there's no one way to solve these problems, but whatever I'm going to do next needs to cancel the inches. In terms of units, that's all I've got. And since I don't want to have it when I'm done, it needs to go away. So whatever I'm going to multiply it by is going to have inches in the denominator, so they cancel. Now, the numerator can vary. Ideally, if I want to do this in the shortest possible number of steps, the numerator needs to create the unit I want to end up with, in this case, feet. So in fact, if I know the relationship between feet and inches, I can do this problem in one step. My conversion factor cancels inches and creates feet. If I don't know it in one step, I can go from inches to something else and eventually get my way to feet. But the first thing I'm always going to do is always cancel the unit I have and create an equivalent unit that will get me hopefully closer to a solution to my problem. In this case, as we've already seen, 1 foot is 12 inches, and so I use that as a ratio, again equal to 1. Essentially I've divided both sides by 12 inches to create a rather awkward looking 1. This ratio is just a 1, and so I can multiply it by my height and not get any taller. And as you can see, because I've got feet in the numerator and inches in the denominator, the inches cancel and I'm left with the unit I want, feet. And so I'm actually 6.08 feet tall. Now, that's actually only two significant figures. And if you want to know how I know that, check out the other video on significant figures. And so I round that to 6.1 feet. And I have my answer. Now, you can also do this with much more complicated problems, and we'll look at that later. But in general, every step along the way is a whole series of ones. And so if I didn't know directly how many feet in an inch, I could have gone from inches to millimeters, and then I need to get rid of millimeters because I don't want to end up with that, so I find a relationship between maybe millimeters and miles, and then maybe miles and yards, and then maybe yards and feet. And so it took me 4 steps instead of the 1 step it took you, but in the end I've got feet, and since we both ended up with feet, we're both in the right place. So all I need is 1 or 10 conversion factors, which in each application simply changes one unit into another. Even this longer 4-step process, if you look at each step separately, all it does is cancel the unit I had previously and create a new unit. And then the next step canceled the unit and created a new unit. So every step is simply changing units. Now, that might seem too simple, and it is a simple example that I'm sure you could have done without my spending 10 minutes talking about it. But in fact, most chemistry boils down to converting units from one material into another material. And so if we get to be very expert in applying this method, a lot of the chemistry problems become fairly straightforward. And so my method here is always the same. I obsess over my units. And so I start by asking myself, what unit am I starting with? This is usually the thing given to you in the problem. And then I ask myself the sometimes harder question, what is it that I want to know unit-wise? Where do I want to end? And then I simply need to find a path that gets me from the beginning to the end. And this path is made up of nothing but conversion factors, each one of which eliminates the unit I'm starting with and gives me a new unit that's hopefully either the unit I want to end up with or something closer to it. And so I take 1 or 10 conversion factors and create a path from the unit I started with to the unit I want to end up with.